Students, I am Dr. Prakash. I welcome you all for the presentation on the subject e-business of 6th semester BBA. In this session number 10, I will be discussing about the topic VPNs. VPN stands for Virtual Private Network. A virtual private network is a technology that creates a safe and encrypted connection over a less secure network such as the internet. Virtual private network is a way to extend a private network using a public network such as internet. The name only suggests that it is virtual private network. That is, user can be the part of local network sitting at a remote location. It makes use of tunneling protocols to establish a secure connection. VPN, meaning that it is a private point-to-point connection between two machines or networks over a shared or public network such as the internet. A virtual private network is a combination of software and hardware. VPN technology can be used in organizations to extend its safe encrypted connection over less secure internet to connect remote users, branch offices and partner private internet network. VPN turns the internet into a simulated private WAN. Now let us understand VPN by example. Think of a situation where corporate office of a bank is situated in Washington, USA. This office has a local network consisting of, say, 100 computers. Suppose another branch of the bank are in Mumbai, India, and Tokyo, Japan. The traditional method of establishing a secure connection between head office and branch was to have a leased line between the branches and head office, which was very costly as well as troublesome job. VPN let us overcome this issue in an effective manner. This is not only a single reason I should choose to use VPN. It also provides some amazing features which are listed below. VPN also ensures security by providing an encrypted tunnel between client and VPN server. VPN is used to bypass many blocked sites. VPN facilitates anonymous browsing by hiding your IP address. Also, most appropriate search engine organization is done by analyzing the data from VPN providers, which provide country-wise stats of browsing a particular product. This method of SEO is used widely by many internet marketing managers to form new strategies. Now let's move on to the types of VPN. VPN is of three kinds. The first one is remote access VPN. The VPN which allows individual users to establish secure connections with a remote computer network is known as remote access VPN. There is a requirement of two components in a remote access VPN, which are as follows. The first one is Network Access Server or NAS, and the second one Client Software. It enables the remote connectivity using any internet access technology. Here, the remote user launches the VPN client to create a VPN tunnel. Intranet VPN. If a company has one or more remote locations and the company wants to join those locations into a single private network, then that company can create an intranet VPN so that they can connect LAN of one site to another one. Intranet VPN can link corporate headquarters, remote offices, and branch offices over a shared infrastructure using the dedicated connections. If you use intranet VPN, then it reduces the WAN bandwidth cost. The user can also connect new sites easily by using this network. The second one is extranet VPN. If a company has a close relationship with the other company, then the company can be the customer, supplier, branch, and another partner company, then those companies can build an extranet VPN so that they can connect LAN of one company to the other. It allows all of the companies to work in a shared environment. The extranet VPN facilitates e-commerce. Now let us see the types of VPN. There are three network protocols are used within VPN tunnels. That are Internet Protocol Security. We can make use of this protocol for encryption. It is used as a protocol suite. It is used as a protocol suite for securing Internet Protocol communications by authenticating and encrypting each packet of IP of a data stream. It requires expensive, time-consuming client installations, which is its most significant disadvantage. The second one is point-to-point tunneling protocol. Generally, it is the most widely used VPN protocol among Windows users. It was created by Microsoft in association with other technology companies. The most significant disadvantage of PPTP is that it does not provide encryption. It relies on point-to-point protocol. It is implemented for the security measures. It is also available for Linux and Mac users. As compared to other methods, PPTP is a faster method. Then the third one is secure socket layer. So before this, we have one more layer to tunneling protocol under P2P tunneling protocol. It is another tunneling protocol which supports VPN. L2TP is created by Microsoft and Cisco as a combination between PPTP and L2F, that is layer 2 forwarding. Layer 2 forwarding also does not provide encryption as it has PPTP. The main difference between both of them is that L2TP delivers data confidentially and data integrity. The third one, as I already said, the secure socket layer or SSL, is a VPN accessible via HTTPS over a web browser. Its most significant advantage is that it does not need any software installed because it uses the web browser as the client application. With the help of SSL VPN, the user's access can be restricted to specific clients instead of allowing access to the whole network. Data sent across the public internet is generally not protected from curious eyes, but you can make your internet communication secure and extend your private network with a virtual private network connection. VPN uses a technique known as tunneling to transfer data securely on the internet to a remote access. The internet connection over the VPN is encrypted and secure. New authentication and encryption protocols are enforced by the remote access server. Sensitive data is hidden from the public, but it is securely accessible to appropriate users through a VPN. VPN and its legality can be discussed now. Using VPN is legal in most of the countries. The legality of using a VPN service depends on the country and its geographical relations with another country as well. A reliable and secure VPN is always legal if you are not intended to use for any illegal activities like to commit a fraud online, cyber theft, or in some countries to download copyrighted content. China has decided to block all VPN by next year, as per report of Bloomberg. Many Chinese internet users use VPNs to privately access websites that are blocked under China's so-called Great Firewall. This is done to avoid many information leakage to rival countries and so as to tighten the information security. Thank you.